Hello everypony, this is Ashy101, here to bring you my July update video. So, I'm briefly just going to explain some things that I have ideas for this month. I'm actually, surprisingly guys, I don't really have too much to talk about, but that's why you saw in the title my UP trip. I'm going to be talking more about that than I am with different subjects, because I know some of you have been asking, how did that go? And I talked a little bit about it in my last pony talk, my Equestria Girls Pony Talk podcast, but some of you asked if I could talk more about it, and this is what this video is all about. So, first, before we even talk about any of that, we are going to jump right into the subjects. So first and foremost, guys, I wanted to talk about a little bit about Dashy's Craft. Dashy's Craft, I want to elaborate on more. I want to get more craft videos out for you guys. I want to do more tutorial videos on it. And I just want to get more people involved with it, you know? I really like doing Dashy's Craft, and most of you know that I do love crafting, doing all this cool stuff, showing my ideas to you guys. That's what is really awesome, and that's why Dashy's Craft still exists today. I know I mentioned that a couple in my other videos, but we are going to do more Dashy's Craft, and I cannot wait for it. Second thing I wanted to talk about is the 200 subscriber special. So, many of you know I've been talking about it for a while, as I do when we hit certain points or goals during the channel. Sometimes I don't get it out on time, which this is one of those times, unfortunately. As all of you know, I have busy life ahead of me, and I just haven't been able to release that out for you. And this is why this week it's going to happen. I'm working on it right now. Should be all good. I cannot wait to release it to you guys. There are some special things in there that you will see in that video. It will be amazing. Not only are you getting a room tour, but you also are getting new different stuff on the channel. So the third thing, and probably the last thing I want to talk about, is gaming videos. I got a couple of games in mind, guys. Plus, we need to finish Benny and the Ink Machine, because I know Chapter 3 is going to be coming out soon, and so far I'm really enjoying the game. I probably should have put a little more time and effort into Chapter 1, because some of you told me, well, I shouldn't say that. I should say I should find more music choices, because the music really took away from my Chapter 1 of Benny and the Ink Machine, as some of you have said. But I really enjoyed the game, and I want to do more with it, so Chapter 2 will be 10 times better, and yeah, we're going to have more gaming content out for you guys, because I know most of you are here for the games, and some of you might be sick of vlogs all the time, and I totally understand that. I would want to see gaming as well. This is what this channel is mostly about, is gaming. I don't know if some of you know that, but gaming is definitely the number one thing on here, but right now it does not seem like it is that way. So now guys, this is the part where I start talking about my trip to the Upper Peninsula, or the UP for short, and yes. So first of all, just to get it out of my hand so you guys aren't questioning this, because I know I'm going to get a lot of questions on this. Yes, I do live in the state of Michigan, so, that's out of the way there. But one thing that this guy has not done is been to the UP, and I know that sounds very, very silly, but yes, it's true. The closest I've been to the UP is Mackinac, and as some of you know, the Mackinac Bridge, Mackinac Island, all those Mackinac words and stuff like that. But that's the closest I've been to the UP. But I never crossed the bridge, nor have I been, of course, to the Upper Peninsula. So, this summer, I have successfully done that. And, oh my gosh, guys, what a blast did I have. Now, I'm going to say this. It gets really cold up there. but it sometimes likes to get hot too. There's a lot of trees, a lot of nature and all that pretty stuff. I mean, down here in the Lower Peninsula, we get a lot of that too, but with like, when you go to the Upper Peninsula, it's like, wow. And internet access is not that well up there, but that's kind of for a good reason. And why I say that is, come on, most of us are on our electronics like 24/7, so I can even admit to that. I'm a little too technology, and sometimes I need to go outside and do stuff. So, me and the troop, our Boy Scout troop, went up to the UP, and we did a lot of different and cool, neat stuff. And I'll show you guys a couple of pictures. You'll see some of when we were by Lake Superior. You'll see some pictures at the lighthouse. You'll see a lot of cool, neat pictures that I took. And you'll also see a couple of videos. Now, I know I didn't mention anything about videos, anything of the sort, but I did take some videos just because there were some interesting things there and some kind of interesting things, but it was like, I need to make a video on this. So, without further ado, you will see those right now.
So this is like the most craziest tag place that I've seen. Look at this. Look at how tagged this is. Just a lot of, yeah, a lot of interesting stuff is up here, guys. Yeah. But it's really nice. It's really pretty. Look at the view. Yeah, it's really nice. Really beautiful. You can see we're up quite a distance if you take a look here. Yeah, it's pretty far down. Yep. Pretty crazy. Here we are, guys. Lake Superior. Very, very nice. Yes, we are in the Upper Peninsula right now, and we got a couple of guys over there. And yeah. Very, very nice. Now, I know I told you guys that I would be taking pictures instead, but it's so beautiful. Nice.
So guys, that was my trip to the UP. I had a lot of fun. There were some miscalculations and misconceptions during our trip, but that's kind of every camping adventure. You never can get it just right. But we had lots of fun. It did rain, but we managed to get through it. Mosquitoes were bad there, but managed to get through it once again. And then I got a couple of stuff here I would like to show you. First of all, they had, you probably saw pictures of the lighthouse and the shipwreck museum. This is where I got this from. So, it is Build Your Own Edmund Fitzgerald. It's a wooden model kit that I'll be putting together. And this is one of those Dashie's Craft things that I've been talking to you about. This is going to be really cool. It's one of the first wooden model ships that I actually done. The last one I actually did was a really small model of the Titanic, which I was okay with, but this one is just filled with detail, and I'm going to add some more stuff to it as I do with a lot of my model kits. Now, when I went, they have a store underneath the Mackinac Bridge, if you did not know, and they sell a lot of cool historical stuff. Well, this was something that I was not ever thinking they were going to sell, but they did, and I decided to get it. And this is U.S. belt buckle from the Civil War. It's not an actual one, it's a reproduction, of course. But it's really cool, and I just need to get a proper belt to fit it. But I was really happy when I found this, because I do like the Civil War a lot. Maybe not as much as World War II and Titanic story or anything like that, but it's really interesting. It's not from the Civil War, but it definitely was a part of what Mackinac was. And Fort Michilimackinac is, they have a thing there, it's a fort by the British Royal Navy, I believe. And they have this one flag flying around. It looks like they have the United Kingdom flag in the top left corner, and the whole rest of the field of the flag is just red. And they have that flag flying everywhere, and they do ceremonies and stuff. It's really cool. So, one thing I wanted to get was of that flag. So, what did I do? Oh, yes. Yes, yes, yes. I got the flag. Yeah, it is a 3x5 flag, the same size as my Dashie 101 flag, that I showed you guys. But, yes, so you can see right there, and then just the rest of the field is just red. And I actually had this flying when we were at the UP. I actually had this flying underneath, the American flag, of course, at the campsite, because it's kind of a thing, you know, we're in that area. Why not? I bought the flag. And, yeah, so that's why it's kind of out of its package. And right now I'm deciphering what I can do with this, because I'm thinking about hanging it up. But I don't know. I really don't want to do that, because I already have a flag hanging up. And yeah. One other thing I wanted to mention, and I'm going to give a person's channel name out there for you guys to go check out. He actually joined me in the UP trip. He's a scout member. And his channel name is King of Drifters. So make sure you guys go check out his channel. But yeah, or Lord of Drifter. Lord of Drifter is his second channel, but his actual channel is King of Drifters. He released a video. We went to like a little fair thing they were doing, like a little festival. And they had this one radio-controlled purple dinosaur-looking thing. And it was like a mix of a dinosaur and a dragon. I don't know what it was, but it looked really interesting and really freaky. Lord Drifter here, or King of Drifters, decided to record this thing, while another troop member decided to just mess around with it, and it ended up turning out very interesting. But yeah, this thing goes off, and it was just crazy. But this guy was just messing around with it, and it just went all wacko. But you guys will see that video. I'll put it down in the description, as well as his actual channel. And I'll just put down his actual video, so you guys can go check out his content. But until then, guys, that wraps up our July update video. So, thank you so much, as always, for watching. Really means a lot. And if you guys have any requests for any videos, games, in the future, let me know. And if you guys want to join Pony Talk, also let me know on that too. So, until then, guys, thank you so much for watching. As always, please like, share, favorite, and don't forget to subscribe, guys. 200 subscriber special will be out soon, so make sure you look for that. And as always, I gotta dash. Stay 20% cooler. This is Dashy101 signing off, guys. Peace out. So I know this is kind of a weird way to end a video off, looking at a toy model ship, but I noticed something. So this thing sits on my windowsill, and I noticed the flag on the back, just like literally now. Look at that. That looks like the same exact flag I showed you guys. And I know that's not the flag that was on the back of the Titanic. It had a blue field. Yeah, creepy.